empowerment of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
4 years have come and gone. We're here to celebrate the class of 2023 at this Baccalaureate Mass. We recognize as we come together that our lives are filled with many, many blessings, and that those blessings come to us through each other primordially. Let us be grateful as we enter into this celebration. Let us keep our eyes and our ears open to the Word of God, to the presence of the Lord, and to the love and the mercy that God wishes to share with us. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Graciously grant to your church, O merciful God, that, gathered by the Holy Spirit, she may be devoted to you with all her heart and united in purity of intent. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. At Miletus, Paul spoke to the presbyters of the church of Ephesus. Keep your watch over yourselves and over the whole flock, of which the Holy Spirit has appointed you overseers, in which you tend the church of God, that he acquired with his own blood. I know that after my departure, savage wolves will come among you, and they will not spare the flock. And from your own group, men will come forward perverting the truth to draw the disciples away from. So be vigilant and remember that for 3 years, night and day, I unceasingly admonished each of you with tears, and now I commend you to God, and to that gracious word of his that can build you up and give you the inheritance among all who are consecrated. I have never wanted anyone's silver or gold or clothing. You know well that these are very hands, have served my needs and my companions. In every way, I have shown you that by hard work of that sort, we must help the weak. And we must keep in mind the words of the Lord Jesus, who himself said, "It is more blessed to give than to receive." When he had finished speaking, he knelt down and prayed with them all. They were all weeping loudly as they threw their arms around Paul and kissed him, for they were deeply distressed that he had said that they would never see his face again. Then they escorted him to the ship, the word of the Lord.
Sing to God, O King of the earth.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Lifting up his eyes to heaven, Jesus prayed, saying, Holy Father, keep them in your name that you have given me, that they may be one just as we are one. When I was with them, I protected them in your name that you gave me, and I guarded them, and none of them was lost except the son of destruction, in order that the scripture might be fulfilled. But now I am coming to you. I speak this in the world so that they may share my joy completely. I gave them your word, and the world hated them, because they do not belong to the world any more than I belong to the world. I do not ask that you take them out of the world, but that you keep them from the evil one. They do not belong to the world any more than I belong to the world. Consecrate them in truth. Your word is truth. As you sent me into the world, so I send them into the world, and I consecrate myself for them, so that they also may be consecrated in truth. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Class of 2023, you look great this morning. It is wonderful to see you in what will be the graduation attire. Your 4 years coming to an end here at Fenwick. But keep in mind, I just got my copy of the yearbook, and what a great job, again, the yearbook staff did. The title of the yearbook, as you probably have seen by now, is Friars Forever. And that's one of the main messages I want to leave with you today. You belong together. You belong as community together. You are friars forever. My heart is rather full this morning, full with gratitude to God for all of you. As I think about what you've been through in the last 4 years together, through pandemics and all sorts of other obstacles that might have been in your way, you have triumphed because you are friars forever. You've stuck together. You are one. And my heart is rather full this morning as well because these readings are so utterly powerful and so utterly appropriate for our celebration. It's about leave-taking. It's about turning a page and moving on. That poignant story about Paul saying goodbye to the people of Ephesus. They were beside themselves. They were weeping. They knew that they wouldn't see Paul again in this life, we should say, bracketing that. But Paul knows that it's time for him to go, and it's time for them to get to work. They will be empowered by the Holy Spirit. They have each other. They are building community together. They are experiencing the love of God and the goodness of God and the mercy of God in community. They don't need Paul any longer. They have what it takes. And Jesus, in the gospel, we are privileged to have an insight into one of his last prayers during his ministry on earth, prayer to the Father. And what is the Lord Jesus concerned about? He realizes that he must undergo his passion, death, and resurrection. And what is his concern? His concern is for his disciples, his brothers and sisters. He says to the Father, Father, keep them together, keep them one, keep them confident. give them courage, keep them from the evil one, and consecrate them in truth. This celebration marks a milestone in your lives and in the history of Fenwick, and I'd like to take you back 4 years to a hot August morning here in the auditorium, the prayer service for your freshman orientation. You might not remember, but I have a really good memory, actually. I saw to it that the song I Lived was played, because it seemed to me that in terms of Fenwick and in terms of your families, that song kind of hits the nail on the head in terms of our hope for you, that during these 4 years you would truly have lived and that you would have faced all sorts of obstacles and triumphed and fulfilled that hope of ours, because you cooperated with the faculty, with the staff, with your coaches, with campus ministers and everybody here that has your best interest in mind. You truly lived. And today, during the pudding ceremony, I thought, you know what, let's have an inclusio. We're going to hear that song again because those hopes are still the same, that we want you, as you move on from Fenwick, to truly live. Because God wants us to live life abundantly. A life that is marked by loving service and consecration to the truth and commitment to community. You truly have lived, and we've loved watching you do your living. We won't be seeing what you're up to as closely as we have during these 4 years, but we trust that you have received here at Fenwick everything you need for a successful, happy life. So our prayers for you are simply the same prayer that Paul had for his community, the prayer that Jesus had as he enters into his work of salvation. Trust in the Spirit of God that dwells in your hearts. Stay close together. You are friars forever. Of the stoles here. Trust me, they're right down there. Heavenly Father, good and gracious God, we ask for a blessing upon these stoles emblazoned with the Dominican shield. May all who wear them be all the more committed to prayer, study, community, and preaching. And this we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let me invite the Dominican friars up onto the stage as we begin the ceremony.
Open the morning comes. I'm in.
Let us stand now and let us bring before the Lord our prayers for this day.
For the leaders of the church, that God may guide them in furthering Christian unity among all believers throughout the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of governments, may they follow in Jesus' teachings and promote global peace, human dignity, and prosperity. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayer. For the class of 2023, may God bless and guide them as they go forth from Fenwick. We also pray for a safe and recuperative summer for all Fenwick students, staff, and faculty, that all may return to Fenwick safely in the fall. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Fenwick students, as the academic year draws to a close, may the end of the year be an opportunity for reflection upon our lives and all that we learned. We ask God's help in recalling all that we have learned and for the comfort of the Spirit as we prepare for final exams. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to hatred, discrimination, and violence. We pray for all who have died due to gun violence, war, and attacks on life in their many forms in our land and throughout the world. May we and all people experience the conversion of our hearts made possible through the suffering, death, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick or burdened by any kind of difficulty, that they may be healed and find the strength to get through their difficulties, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the deceased, that they may rest in eternal life and be granted peace through Jesus Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, hear the prayers of your people, for we make them all in faith in the name of Jesus, who is Lord forever and ever. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty God.
And Lord, accept the sacrifice of your hands for the grace and glory of this day, for our good and for all his holy Church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifices instituted by your commands, and through the sacred mysteries which we celebrate as our dutiful service, graciously complete the sanctifying work by which you are pleased to redeem us, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For after his resurrection, he plainly appeared to all his disciples and was taken up to heaven in their sight, that he might make us sharers in his divinity. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Blaise, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever. Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. Partaking of this divine sacrament, O Lord, constantly increase your grace within us, and by cleansing us with its power, make us always ready to receive so great a gift. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A huge thank you to all who made this celebration possible. Grateful to Mr. Conlon and the sound crew, our wonderful musicians, as always, who have helped us pray your excellence. And so as we go forward, my last one of these for you, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord through one another.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Good morning, everyone.
Put yourself on. Thank you. I would now like to introduce our speaker for this morning. She is headed off to the University of Illinois, Champaign-Urbana, to study business. A presidential award winner involved in a host of activities, including National Honor Society, Friar Mentors, Student Council, Right Place, as well as an athlete across many sports. In her time here at Fenwick, a friend to many, I am pleased to introduce to you Olivia Polston.
Good morning, Fenwick, and what's up, class of 2023? Always anticipated.
and we didn't take anything for granted. We attended events, completed our service project, and cheered each other on as we won state in just about everything. Football, boys cross country, math team, and teams. Then senior year rolled around this past August, and the class of 2023 got right down to the business of being seniors. We took our last first day pictures, we led the student section at sporting events, we attended and led Kairos, and we went to our last homecoming picture party and prom. The car rides to school that as a freshman seemed routine now turned into a catalyst for some of our best memories. Driving to school with friends, having bagels for breakfast in the parking garage, carpooling from Fenwick to the Priory for practices and games, going to support BFG and friends at Bonawa, and driving to watch our basketball team beat OPRF in our Santa hats and Christmas pajamas. So here we are as seniors, finally sitting on the throne that is the middle section of the auditorium, just like all the graduating classes before us. We have made it to the end. The long nights we stayed up studying for tests and writing papers is behind us, at least for a couple months. We'll never again wait in line for half of our lunch period for a Caesar wrap. We won't hear Alessia and Maggie on the PA back with our Friday morning announcements. We'll never look at the seas of underclassmen packed into the field house as we chant four more years at them. And after graduation, this class of 2023, all 275 of us, will never be in the same place again. As freshmen and sophomores, we sat in the passenger seats, the train cars, and our bike seats that pedaled us to school, practice, and home. Now these seats will turn into the seats of airplanes, cars, and much longer train rides across the country to our various college destinations. So class of 2023, we've been on this journey for 4 years together. As I was reflecting on our experience at Fenwick, there are many things that represent us as a class, but I believe that there are three that define us. The first, perseverance. We are unlike any class in nearly a century at Fenwick. Seriously, think about it. We're the only grade in 100 years that is able to say that we survived high school during a pandemic. Our senior class has taught me that no matter how frightening and uncertain things can get, going through a tumultuous time is better with a supportive community such as Fenwick. The second thing that defines us, we've learned to live in the moment. The unique challenges that the class of 2023 overcame not only made us stronger, but also taught us one crucial life lesson. Appreciate the present, or at least try to. You never know when it can be taken away. As we go on to college, we're gearing up for another exciting 4 years of our lives. With the perspective I now have, I wish I could slow down time and savor the small things. We should take advantage of every opportunity to learn and prepare, but also explore, experience, and most of all, remember not to take anything for granted. Juniors, sophomores, freshmen, this applies to you too. Before you know it, you'll be sitting in the coveted middle section, listening to one of your classmates reflect on your time at Fenwick. Hopefully you were able to live in the moment. The third and perhaps most important defining characteristic of our class, our faith. Through our short 4 years here at Fenwick, we have grown in our faith and Christian belief. Our theology classes, prayer, all school masses, and our Kairos retreats give us hope and comfort when situations seem unclear. We owe gratitude to Father Petticord, the friars, campus ministry, the theology department, and all faculty at Fenwick who got us through both their words and actions, and of course, their fist bumps at the atrium doors. Most importantly, we learn to believe and have faith in ourselves and discover who we are through both success and failure. It is this deeper faith in God, those around us, and ourselves that have made us ready to leave Fenwick, prepared for the next part of our journey. In the end, I realized Fenwick wasn't just a place we commuted to from our homes for the past 4 years. The trains, cars, buses, and bikes were just a means to get us to this special place that taught us to persevere, to live in the moment, and to grow in our faith. So as we go forth from this Mass and across the stage at graduation, we can take comfort in knowing our commute to school was not only from houses to school, but from our first home to our second home, a place that will always welcome us back. Class of 2023, let me be the first to say it. We did it. Congratulations and go Friars.
Was created by none other than the very talented Ava Saunders. And with that, I hope you respectfully enjoy this year's senior video. Congratulations, Class of 2023.
We don't have Facebook this Sunday. Look what I found. It's our senior year. Never see that.
No experience within one building is universal. To write within the confines of one perspective would be an unfaithful representation of what each student sitting here at Fenwick has lived for these past 4 years. 4 years of first-year nerves fading into the comfort of a routine, of a haphazardly assembled lunch table becoming your new favorite group of people, of becoming bolder with introductions and dress code violations, and smiles in the hallways, of realizing that your best friend used to be that stranger from second period. 4 years, ultimately, of growth, different for each person. Finally finding a home in your team or leaning into the independence that you once feared, while we each hold within us our own distinct personal revelations and accomplishments, each its own representation of life within this school, we are ultimately united, not merely through the attendance of football games or a unanimous love of the cafeteria's cookies, but through the shared fact that no matter how largely we may differ from one another. We've all grown under one shared roof. The communal joy of Spirit Week, or a big win in sports, or the last day before a break is something many of us share in regard to some of our most electric experiences at Fenwick. The space we hold in our hearts for those memories is infinite. As students who have walked through these halls since the ancient year of 2019, our greatest point of solidarity as a class is our transformation. It is one that all seniors experience, yet ours is Friars, especially as we begin to take on our next phase of life beyond Fenwick. We take with us what we have gained these last few years. This four-year metamorphosis of identity and ability we, both individually and as a community, have undergone, will forever serve as a testament to our strength. It is proof that we are forced to be reckoned with. This is what makes us Friars. We're not afraid. We have an entire family of peers which we have grown alongside that sustain us. We are innovative. We are curious beings that embrace the changes that comfort us, allowing them to remold and enhance our ever-growing intellectual minds. Most of all, we're full of love. Infinite compassion is alive in us, born from our tumultuous, gratifying experience in these past crucial years. Through our lives, we will share this gift with those we come by and allow new friendships to enter into our eternally expanding hearts. From our time at Fenwick, we will carry with us these qualities as tokens of our past, an armor for our future. We will never forget who we are. We are the class of 2023.
My favorite memory was definitely Mr. Perry's 6-7 English. Junior year, Seamus Dunlap, the loudest boo of all time. If you're remembering that, Duke St. Ignatius to ruin their undefeated season, beating them at their house on their own going.
My favorite in physics class, I'm not going to name drop, but this kid had a cup of water, or an empty cup, we thought it was empty on his desk, and he pretended to like throw it at me, but it actually had water in it, and it just went all over my face.
Me and Margaret had no shooting together sophomore year on the very first day of lab. We broke two crucibles right after the lab.
It was after the safety presentation too.
Yes. We also set fire on our
classes. So, Mr. Wicked lit up us.
And I got a 3-3 freshman year for saying poop in a mean way.
But I would sit in her room every day and chew gum. Like, every day. And she never knew that she
did. There's one time freshman year when we were eating lunch and Dennis had chocolate milk and he spilled it all over himself. So he had to get a new pair of pants. The pants were way too big. And they were like blue too, so he looked really silly. And that was really funny.
Last year I had puke during the fire drill. In the bathroom. It was pretty fun.
Running across the stage in just my boxers.
Time to dance, I dare you.
That's definitely like the long hours spent at crew and BFG, just all winding together into a production at the end.
Horn of the Bells.
I would probably have to say just the entire Pyros experience. The retreat and leading both were so heartwarming and a completely life-changing experience that I wouldn't have had unless I went to Fenwick.
I would definitely say Kairos and then also the sports I played, especially cheer. Instead, I joined my senior year because I only had 1 year on the team, but it was probably my most favorite sport I played at Fenwick.
Probably being in Spanish class and hearing like people hammering on the doors. All those people were stuck in the bathroom.
Oh, yes. I was stuck in the bathroom. What a mania.
When I crashed into 2 cars on the way to school, I had one that I'm like 2 minutes later.
Favorite memory was softball's regional game against Trinity.
I'd probably say September and December Kairos.
Quite a state for diving.
I would say the OPRF volleyball game this year. Crowd was electric.
I would give my freshman year self, I would tell her to just like speak up. And speak up for yourself and as well as others and like do the things that you love to do and don't worry about academics. I mean, I got there, so.
know that everything works out, and enjoy the journey.
Talk to Aaron Johnson more.
Transfer to Fenwick.
Do your homework.
Yeah, I'd probably say do my homework too.
Mine would be not to be shy, because now I realize that we're all people. Like, just reach out, say hi. Like, one simple smile could just change anybody's day. So
yeah, be more outgoing, make the memories, and have no regrets. I would say my freshman self, get involved, take it all in, really goes by fast.
I would say that the people that you meet on the first day of school are going to become your best friends for the next 4 years.
Start strong.
You're going to go.
Relax. Not everything needs to be like the most stressful thing in the world.
I know everyone says it goes by fast, but it really does.
I remember the first day in the auditorium, they were like, it's going to fly by so fast. And
I was like, I didn't believe
yeah,
that.
They were like, yeah, right. Nah. And now we're here.
The best thing about being a Fenwick student is just like the overwhelming love and support you receive from people. And just like being able to say hi to so many different people in the hallways, and teachers knowing your name and helping you.
Just being surrounded by people with the same drive and like determination and motivation to work hard.
Yeah, I would say it's like the family that is formed while being a Fenwick, right?
Yeah, I agree.
It's gotta be the community and the chicken Caesar wraps.
I think what I'm gonna miss the most is my morning practices almost every day.
I came into Fenwick not knowing anyone. I came from a public middle school and elementary, but the people that I met on day one and that are still with me, supporting me, are amazing, and I miss them the most.
Probably how hyped they'd be up at the like games and stuff, like the jumping, the chants, all that. Like I'll let them.
I would say tell people where that you go. It's a film where they look at you in like a totally different way. They most definitely think that you're smarter now.
Yeah, I would say like you play for the Shield.
Ben Mall.
No,
I would say loving.
I'm changing.
Sentimental. Amazing.
Electric.
I was gonna say that.
Memorable.
Special.
It's home. Like I feel like it's become a second.
And for me, I see like family
and true.
Probably home. This place feels like a second home to me, and I'm really gonna miss it.
Amazing. Special.
Extraordinary. Short.
I think I might have said this, but I'm gonna go with home.
I'm just gonna say valuable. A lot of valuable friendships, valuable education.
Family. Home.
Spectacular.
Unforgettable.
I would have to say memorable. It's something I'll never forget.
Heartwarming.
Life-changing. Definitely life-changing.
Thank you. second period.